Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back again with some latest space updates. First of all, we'll talk about SpaceX's progressing Mechazilla test campaign, then we'll talk about the Transporter 3 launch, we'll wrap up with Virgin Orbit's first launch of the year. So let's begin our first update as another progressive step taken by SpaceX for the test of stability and reliability of the Mechazilla catch system. Presently, the test campaign of Mechazilla catch arms is going on well in the SpaceX Starbase. They started the process of proof testing those arms about almost a week ago. Their test campaign had begun with basic calibration of the catch arms and followed by one minor and one major test of both the catch arms and the Mechazilla carriage, which helps in upward and downward movement of the arms in the exterior of orbital launch tower. Recently, SpaceX teams have started the immense stress test of the Mechazilla arms. For that purpose, they're using giant-sized ballast water balloons to simulate the weight of Starship and Super Heavy. On the 11th of January, SpaceX teams started installing 6 giant-sized water bags from the massive steel arms. They first installed 3 water bags on each side of the Starship simulator frame. According to some reports, those huge and heavy-duty water balloons were subject to routine stress tests of various large structures and devices. Then, when the water bags were possibly empty, SpaceX headed to move the catch arms up and down the full length of the launch tower at a higher speed than the earlier tests. It took almost 7 minutes for the Mechazilla to go up and down almost 120 meters along the tower. As per reports, the Mechazilla carriage maintained an average speed of 1 kilometer per hour. SpaceX engineers used those water bags for simulating rocket weight, as it would be too inconvenient and expensive too in using actual rockets for mere test purposes. And using the original rocket also involves some risk of damage to either the rocket or the tower or to both in case of any failure with the arms in the prior tests. Sources state that it's estimated that the 6 water bags taken to use by SpaceX would be of either 20, 35, or 50-ton variants. It's expected that if all the bags would be completely filled, then it would weigh in between 120 tons to even 300 tons. The weight range is almost perfect for simulating the dry mass of Starship or Super Heavy. On the 12th of January, 2022, SpaceX proceeded to fill up the giant bags with water. In all appearances, SpaceX fully filled around 4 of the 6 bags and partially filled the other 2. The arm structure sagged quite a bit while the water balloons were filled. They also lifted the arms with this load for about 10 to 20 meters and also carried out some sideways moves of the arms. They also partially demonstrated the process of rotating a lifted Starship or Super Heavy into position for either stacking or launch mount installation. At 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, SpaceX fully drained out the water from the weight simulator bags. It's now expected that this load testing will now repeat for over the next several days or weeks to ensure reliability. Then they'll head for practical use rather than a simulated one. Now we'll talk about SpaceX's recent Transporter 3 launch. On the 13th of January, 2022, SpaceX successfully launched the 2nd rocket of the year for carrying out the Transporter 3 mission. At about 10:25 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, the Falcon 9 rocket lifted off from Space Launch Complex 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, Florida, delivering almost 105 small satellites to orbit. The booster used in this mission was B-1058. This mission was Falcon 9 B-1058's 10th orbital-class launch in just 19 months, averaging one launch every 59 days. B-1058 had actually managed 8 launches in less than a year, approximately one launch in every 45 days. After landing, SpaceX announced, "Stage 1 landing is confirmed." Kate Tice, SpaceX's reliability engineering manager, said, "As you heard, the Falcon 9 has landed for the 10th time. This marks our 102nd overall recovery." About 9 minutes after launch, the rocket touched down on a landing pad just a mile away from the launch site. For recovering the payload fairing, SpaceX has already deployed one of its newest recovery vessels, named Bob. This time, SpaceX's Transporter 3 rideshare mission was supported by companies specifically like Spaceflight Inc. and ExoLaunch. These companies had practically helped the SmallSat customers to book a ticket to space through them. Derek Tournier, director of the Space Development Agency, SDA, stated, "The Transporter mission concept is unique. If you're orbit agnostic, this is a perfect service. You don't have to wait a long time for launches, you just book the flight when you're ready and go." According to some reports, ExoLaunch, which is practically a company that helps customers to get part in rideshare missions, has launched a satellite for New Space, a startup company of Singapore, on SpaceX's Transporter 3 mission. Jean Medvedeva, VP Launch at ExoLaunch, said, "New Space is our first customer from Singapore, and we're very pleased to extend our presence in this region. Impressed by what the team of New Space has achieved so far, we're proud to have provided a one-stop launch solution within a very short time frame under the SpaceX's rideshare program, and to have successfully integrated NUX-1 with Falcon 9 for launch later this month." Another launch broker of Italy, D-Orbit, has also launched their free-flying transfer stage, Ion SCV-004, in this Transporter 3 mission. Report says this free-flying transfer stage will first deploy itself from Falcon 9's upper stage, and then it will deploy satellites of the customers into orbit. The largest of the 105 satellites is the Ukrainian SIC-2-1 satellite. This Ukrainian Earth imaging satellite weighs about 170 kilograms. A pair of satellites was also launched in this SpaceX rideshare mission for both ICEYE of Finland and Capella Space. Earth imaging company Planet 44's Super Dove satellites were also part of the mission. A student group of Israel has also sent 8 Tevel CubeSats as payloads. These satellites will provide amateur radio communications in low Earth orbit. 5 small satellites were from Spire Global, while Kepler Communications, a Canadian data relay company, had sent a group of 4 CubeSats to orbit. 3 MDA sats were sent too. They're part of the South African government's effort to attempt to track and monitor maritime traffic. Umbra, too, had launched the second satellite of their expanding constellation, weighing about 65 kilograms, that will be able to provide the highest-resolution commercial radar images from space. SpaceX now has plans to carry out 2 more Transporter rideshare launches later this year. The company has as many as 3 more Falcon 9 launches scheduled for the second half of January, including Starlink 4-6, CSG-2 Earth Observation Satellite launch, and Starlink 4-7 launch. We'll wrap up with Virgin Orbit's 3rd consecutive successful operation flight of Launcher 1. On the 13th of January, Virgin Orbit launched 7 CubeSats into orbit aboard their Launcher 1 air launch system. Dan Hart, president and chief executive of Virgin Orbit, said, "Our ability to achieve a 45-degree inclination out of the West Coast significantly increases the utility of a launch out of the West Coast. That kind of flexibility is unprecedented." Virgin Orbit changed the deploy position for this launch compared to earlier ones, relocating it to the west-southwest, outermost over the Pacific. This change in deploy position supported the rocket to place the satellite into an orbit with an inclination of 45 degrees. As per Virgin Orbit, this launch with such an inclination was first of its own from the West Coast launch site. According to sources, at approximately 4:39 p.m. Eastern Time, the Cosmic Girl aircraft took off from the Mojave Air and Spaceport in California. Cosmic Girl is actually a Boeing 747 aircraft used by Virgin Orbit as a launch platform for their Launcher 1 rocket. At nearly 5:52 p.m. Eastern Time, Cosmic Girl released the Launcher 1 rocket. The rocket then continued to climb to low Earth orbit at an altitude of almost 500 kilometers. Almost an hour after Launcher 1's separation from Cosmic Girl, Virgin Orbit stated that all seven satellites had been deployed. In this launch, these seven small sats have come from three of Virgin Orbit's customers. According to a report, four of the satellites came from the Defense Department's Space Test Program, out of which two CubeSats were the Pathfinder for Autonomous Navigation, HAN, to test a rendezvous and docking system, one CubeSat for Technology Education Satellite, TechEdSat 13, and another CubeSat is the Global Star Evaluation and Risk Reduction Satellite, GEARS 3. Two satellites from Sat Revolution, a Polish smallsat developer, Stork 3 and StreamSat 2, and one satellite from Spire Global were also part of this mission.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.